Okay, hang on to your hats because we're in for a fun ride today. Teresa has used some new dazzles and some new embossing folders.
Wonderful. 13 new dazzles that we're going to show you, some of them with never before seen finishes.
Yes, pretty, pretty.
And 4 new embossing folders, and wait till you see what magic Teresa has done with them.
That's right.
Come play with us.
And ta-da, here are the dazzles. Now, if you're counting them quickly, you're counting 11. Gail said there are 13.
I did.
Well, there are 13 new ones, but Teresa has used 11 of them.
Okay.
So we'll just be showing those to you in different webisodes.
Absolutely. But look at those beautiful dazzles. We have double stick. We have this beautiful new finish of that fuchsia mirror and that lime mirror. Those are just gorgeous. We have gnomes. We have jewel bird dazzles. Do you want me to go through them, or are we going to go one?
We'll go through them one at a time. So there's more of those, and there are also,
beautiful,
as you said,
embossing folders.
Embossing folders. So we've got patterned hearts.
Mm-hmm.
We have the trio of flowers. We have an oval rose, which I think is gorgeous, and then a fancy flourish, which is really kind of fun because you can turn it different ways
Isn't
and do different
wonderful?
Things with it. So
okay.
Lots of stuff, lots of techniques. So let's get started.
I wonder if I should hand you the dazzle.
Yeah,
so
would you?
Okay, I'm going to be doing demos on these gorgeous cards.
So we have the floral trio, and look what Teresa has done. And in this case, she has done the embossing on watercolor paper, and you know we carry that. But she's also used those beautiful iridescent watercolors.
Iridescent watercolors. And I want you to see the inside, too, before
okay.
we move on. I also think that she used what do we call this?
The card.
There we go.
Flaps and borders. So she's used. That's interesting. Put it on top.
To just use it on the paper.
Very
and
nice.
Use it as a border. So that's beautiful.
She also commented that she used the dazzles as she would a ribbon.
All right.
And I think that's
mm-hmm.
really an interesting comment to make.
Right. So we've got the border dazzles.
Right.
We've got the jewel dazzles
mm-hmm.
and that beautiful new fuchsia
Should
mirror.
We get in close up here? John, take us in close, please. There you go. Very
Isn't that
pretty.
Beautiful.
Just very sweet. Okay, back us up.
And after you see the inside, I'll show you the technique for the front there.
Wow.
So she has used both of those embossing folders.
Right.
So you've got basically 2 card fronts here.
You do.
This the oval rose
it's
on
very
the front.
Often with Teresa.
Sure.
So what did she do? Obviously,
okay.
she embossed on watercolor paper.
She did. So she started with watercolor paper and the Cosmic Shimmer iridescent watercolor paints. And something that she said, which I thought was a great idea, is that she spritzed a little bit of water just on the colors that she was going to use for this. These are the antique shades. And she used this one, and this one. And I've got a water brush, and I've got that watercolor paper. And she just started by brushing some of those colors across, and she sort of did it at an angle like this, I noticed. And, you know, kind of various areas. You just start with one color, wash your brush off. And
so don't worry about being too precise.
Right.
Is that what you're telling
add
me?
Add another color like so, and then add the next color. So you've got a little bit of all. And if you add a little bit more water, you're going to get a little bit more muted. She wanted to blend in between those layers. And when you're done doing that, you have a piece that's all watercolored the whole way across. Then you're going to place it inside your embossing folder. And she said she waited for it to dry mostly, but not all the way. She wanted it a little bit damp, and that really gives you a good impression when you pull it out of that beautiful embossing folder. Now you can see it, but you can't see it
clearly. Yeah.
So then she takes the Timber Brown Stays On.
Oh, I would have thought it was the black. But
no,
it's the Timber Brown.
Okay. Because she wanted it just a little bit muted, not too dark. And you see that I'm just sort of swiping it. I do it a little bit in a in circular motion, and I try to stay away from those large areas. I don't really want it on the edges. I just want it on that raised embossed area.
So just lightly.
Just lightly. And when you're all done, you've got the beautiful look that you see.
Yeah.
She did the same thing on the inside, so the same look.
Very pretty.
Gorgeous. Oh,
so
easy.
Striking.
Very
I love how
easy.
Big that is.
Mm-hmm. So
and
you don't
again,
have to be a watercolor pro to be able to do that, you'll notice.
That sounds nice. Yeah. That's helpful. And that, again, is the card flaps and borders cutting die, just turned going each way.
Right.
And beautifully framed with those dazzles. Mm-hmm. Okay, nice beginning.
Okay.
So that is our floral trio. Now we're going to go into that fancy flourish.
Beautiful.
And she has turned it like so.
But you can turn it any way.
You can.
Make it a vertical,
yes,
or a horizontal. Isn't that
and
beautiful?
And look how pretty that is.
And
wow,
you're getting that effect with Inca Gold. And she used three different Inca Golds. She's got copper, gold, and she actually used apricot on the inside. So the copper looks like that.
And I love copper.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yes.
Gold, and that the apricot is actually my favorite. You want to show the inside?
Yeah, let me show you the inside. Isn't so that's beautiful? Where the apricot.
Oh, I just love that.
Apricot.
Apricot. Okay. Yeah, you say apricot,
very
I say apricot. Isn't that beautiful? So, all right, I've got a craft sheet. I have a cardstock. Brown cardstock, I ran it through the embossing folder.
Brown, interesting.
And we want to remember not to put our fingers into the Inca Gold because it can contaminate it. You just take a little bit of it at a time. I'm going to get a little bit of the gold and a little bit of the, what did we call
copper.
It? Copper.
Mm-hmm.
And then she took her finger at this point and applied it like so. So I've got them mixed up here. That's not going to matter much. Just sort of rub it across in different areas. And you can do them together,
you can do them separately. You know, I like it just over the top as you're, oh, isn't that pretty when they blend?
Right, oh. Ooh. Yeah, sure. So look, she's got it all over.
Yeah, she really did it solid.
Really solid, but you can just, if I'm careful, I can just get it on the top of those raised areas so that, mm-hmm, you can make that stand out all by itself.
Either way.
Or really get it in there, and if you want it to go into all of those recessed areas and really get nice coverage, then you're going to take a baby wipe. She scrunched it up and just sort of started moving things around, and that really helps to get it into the other areas. I'm thinking she put a pretty heavy layer on there.
Yeah.
And then did that, and you're really getting it. Isn't it just gorgeous?
It is gorgeous, and how beautifully they blend without becoming muddy, and I appreciate that.
Right. So
it looks like metal.
There's your look. The more I do it, the more blended it gets. Beautiful.
Now, I see butterflies on here.
Right.
And these butterflies are from the new little accents. These are the double stick dazzles. So that means they're sticky on both sides.
That's right.
They're translucent.
And while she put it right on top of there, I've just got a piece of brown cardstock here so that we can see it really easily. So here they are, the double stick. They always come with this plastic layer on top.
Right.
You keep it on here to keep them from getting messy and
dirty. They'll pick
dirty.
Up. Yeah,
right.
Sure they will.
So you peel it back just enough to get the dazzle that you want. Peel off the dazzle.
I know it's hard to see
back on there
because it's clear.
You'll be able to see it here in just a second.
There you go.
So there you go. We've got it just laying there on the cardstock. We've got solar gold and imperial garnet silk microfine glitter.
Okay.
Microfine, they sure are, and they are really beautiful when you're done with them. So just a little bit is all.
And you can
use
any of the glitters. It's just that the microfine, because it is such a small size, it just is a very beautiful look.
Right.
And
this is the silk microfine. Uh-huh. It feels even, right. I mean, it feels silky when you're rubbing your finger across it. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to tap it off. And then I'm going to do it again a couple of times until it's really burnished in there and you get this nice shiny layer. And absolutely beautiful.
So you would place that right onto the embossed
Inca
Gold
there.
Piece.
That's right. And do it right on the front of that card.
And Teresa added some pearls in one of her signature bow designs. Mm-hmm. Then she's also added the new long greetings dazzles. And I have to tell you, I love these.
I
think
do too.
The look is excellent. You do too?
It's that beautiful script look, and you know, you can even cut them apart if you really want to make them fit in tight places.
So best wishes on the front and celebrate on the inside. And these are with the that second color of glitter.
Yeah, imperial garnet.
That's
another look. They were also using the 28 Lilac Lane Just Peachy embellishments. And so you've got sequins, beads, pearls, and we've been seeing a lot of these this week.
Yeah.
They are
Teresa
so
loves
useful.
Them. Design team
we
loves
love them.
Them.
The colors alone were enough to make me go, ooh, I want one of each.
So you can see. Beautiful. And in this case, just a small portion of that embossed area was used.
Beautiful? Now, I don't know if you noticed this, and I'm just scoot over to the left a little bit. What is this? This is the steampunk papers. Can you imagine that with the butterflies?
Oh,
and
my goodness.
It's such a perfect match. It's absolutely beautiful.
Oh, that's well, and that's Teresa's eye. She just has a wonderful eye for color and so forth. Okay, you ready to move into a gem of something?
Let's do that.
Okay, here are our new Gems and Jewels Dazzles, and they are in a mirror silver.
And because they're mirror silver, it's hard to see on the sheet all together, but once you use them on something, they are so striking.
Now, Teresa's done several things on this card. To begin with, she is using the 3D frame die cut card, so you can see that that's what's happening here.
Should I show you that?
Yeah,
first?
Why don't you show us that?
When you get that, in the package you're going to have patterns for the papers that go on here. But here is the card itself. It starts like this. It is scored so that right here on the spine you can make it do this. So now you've got that 3D effect. It's going to sit up. It's also scored and cut in the center. And you're going to start by pushing those pieces to the back or to the inside of your card. You're going to push to the inside. And then they are each one of those points are scored again so you can pull that back. So each one is going to be pushed back. So now you've got a nice little place right in the center because you have two die cut pieces. One will push right down into the center. I wonder if I've got the right.
No, they're both the same size.
They're both the same size. Okay.
So you just push it in. Of course, you would probably want to cover it with paper first.
I didn't push them back far enough. You've got to create that box in the center. And then slide that right down in place.
It's a really nice fit.
Right, and it glues to those pieces here, and this one glues to the back.
Finishes the back of
Finishes
it.
Finishes it up, and then you've got that 3D box card.
So those gem dazzles are backed on green, and what Teresa used, let's get, yeah,
some
great. You can
green.
See them.
You've got lots of different colors.
This
there.
Is used out of the textured iridescent sheets, and there's a whole bunch of them.
So beautiful.
And
we've used them for lots of different things, but you really
only gorgeous.
Need a little bit.
Yes.
To get that shine with those gems, I just think that is such a natural pairing and wish I had thought of it.
And the other thing that she used, we go back to our patterned hearts. Now, you're getting a silver look. Well, what did that woman use?
Six of those hearts on there. So that patterned hearts embossing folder, six different designs. So you can use this all in one shot.
Right.
Or you can cut them out individually, which I think is a great
idea. So she used the pearl sheets. These are self-adhesive. They have an adhesive backing on them.
Right.
And they're gold and pearl, or gold and silver. But she's used the silver, and then she's tapped them just like you did before. You're going to show that.
With
okay.
The stays
go
on.
Ahead.
I'm just going to show it. I'm not going to do it. Here it is, embossed and ready to cut out. And Teresa cut them out individually. And like you said, she tapped those with just the top of that stays on. You just go like that with your stays on ink pad. And then they're ready to cut out individually. I also wanted to point out that when you do cut them out and then you peel off the adhesive backing, it's embossed. And she says, even the backing off the hearts could be used in a project! Exclamation point.
Don't
That's
throw
Teresa.
It away. What a woman. And look at this. You're a real gem. You've got a border. And then on the inside, she has done more. Now, this is another of the textured iridescent. You can see them. And more of the heart. So, wow. And it's your friendship is priceless. Just really a stunning, very fun card.
Right.
Using lots of fun techniques. Now, we have a scrapbook page. Well, of course we have a scrapbook page. And our scrapbook page has lots of gnomes.
I love this.
Very fun. Now, what Teresa did, well, let's see, let me show you. Okay, here are the gnomes. And there are, let me see, there are 35 pieces
I've got to have this.
You've got to have that?
There are things, the sayings on here are so adorable. Hey, know me. To thankful you from thoughtful me, or from the other way.
To
thoughtful you from thankful me.
Right.
Still.
Okay, so what Teresa did is she did the gnomes And just simply colored them. So she put them on
colored
just cardstock.
Colored them in with Spectrum Noir pen. She likes to concentrate the darker colors around the edges. So
there
that's
you go.
Kind of a nice shadow technique.
And she elected to use the Lime New Border and Fuchsia, Border and Jewel Dazzles
right.
throughout this page. You can see that she's done strips of them.
Right. She also has those long greetings.
Yes, right there. Hooray.
Beautiful.
So we got the little guy.
This is just a great collection of border dazzles going everywhere and the words used as borders.
Smiles down here.
Just little pieces of it here and there. What a nice collection of photos.
Very fun. This is on the hopscotch paper, mm-hmm. which is also fun and bright.
So backing those dazzles and coloring them in with Spectrum Noir.
Yeah, so just a really fun. So she used also... We've got little bluebirds floating mm-hmm. in our photographs. Oh, you can see them all over. Very fun. There's going to be 172 on that
wow.
pack.
Jewel bird dazzles in that nice blue mirror.
Right. It also comes in black, so you've got both. And the lime dazzles, as I talked about, and the gnomes.
And those never-before-seen yes. colors, which are really fun.
So very, very fun. Very fun mm-hmm. page. Nice to see what you can do. And again, it's pretty flat, too. So it's going to work really well for scrapbooking.
Right.
Now we're going to move on to our new coffee mugs in brown dazzles. And Teresa elected to use the fry boxes. These are the Sarah surfaces. So it looks just like a fry box,
so
as you can see.
Great fun. And then you've got the dazzles, Love You More Than Coffee, on the front there. And it's backed on some of these papers and placed on the front of that. So it's a coffee box. That's
it
great.
Is. Now, Teresa's got some instant coffee
right.
from Pike Place up in Seattle. But let me pull this out
yeah.
because
I
in the back.
Who's going to fight over those when we
yeah.
get
mm-hmm. So what she's done in the back is this. So if you just had something small to tuck in
right.
or a piece of jewelry or some
okay.
chocolate.
So
or
I just caught on. These are the Mystic Garden papers, I know, because of the paper
yes.
there. I recognize it. I love
right.
that look there.
Isn't that
it's
pretty?
Mm-hmm.
So very, very fun. So you can put tissue in it if you like.
I'll just take
and
that.
And you'll just take care
I'll
of that for
that
me.
For
you are so kind.
Okay,
our last project is this. Now, Teresa has used the new roses dazzles. Now, as I look at this, I'm thinking, oh, I might have thought that was an embossing folder, but no. Teresa has used the dazzles as a stencil.
Correct.
So surprise, surprise.
And she's also using the Color Burst.
Ah.
So we have color, and I've got them
okay.
here, fuchsia and turquoise. And if you want to grab the pixie powder over there,
okay.
she used all three of those.
I've got the pixie powder in rich gold.
I'm
so we're
stalling for time.
You are stalling for time. You're getting something. Okay, so
okay,
we've got these.
Ready.
So these were used on the back. So you can certainly see the turquoise, the pink. The gold pixie powder is really an iridescence.
Isn't that beautiful?
I want to turn this so the camera can pick it up.
Okay, and
there
I
we
am
go.
Ready.
There you go. You can see how that. both of these products, both the pixie powders and the Color Burst, are concentrated watercolor
right.
powders
right.
or pigments.
They are dry pigments,
yeah.
and we use them, generally we'll have a paper like this, we'll spritz it with water,
mm-hmm.
we'll put those powders right on there. But this time we're going to start with a dazzle, and we're going to use this dazzle as a stencil. Now the first thing that Teresa said is she took a little bit of the tackiness off by putting this on her jeans. So I am putting this on my pants. I sort of stick it on my pants. I know
and
I can't
just
put my leg
it off.
Up here, sorry.
Yeah.
And I don't think I'm that flexible anymore. So now we've got that right on here,
mm-hmm.
and she added several of these
yes, she
dazzles.
Did. She put three.
I'm only going to use
yeah.
one at the moment, but she put three on there. And you can even cut them to make them fit just the way you want
yeah.
if you like. And then I'm going to sprinkle on the powders dry.
Okay.
So, yeah, before she spritzed it, okay. she said she just put this on a little bit. I'm going to put the pink along the center. Just a
like
little
she
bit
did.
Of that, just like she did. And I've got the pink. That's actually the fuchsia. And then
okay.
a little of the teal out on the edges. You never know how this is going to look.
Teal or turquoise?
Turquoise.
Okay.
Around the corners. You never know how it's going to look
don't.
Until you're done. I
and
think
that's
I want a little over there,
too. And that's
the fun
of it. So you just have to be prepared for that.
Right.
Okay.
And even the pixie powders. Now, don't worry about my bottle looks a little different than yours.
Yeah, that's okay.
But it is the same stuff. So a little bit hear. Well, that's probably a little too
or
much.
Or perhaps too much, well, but that's fine.
We will see what happens. Yeah. And then we start spritzing heavily, is what she
heavily,
said.
Heavily, okay.
Spritzing heavily, and we don't want to get it on anything else.
I love how it just magically works. It's very, very
fun.
There
you go. It's spreading all over.
It is.
And then that's pretty heavy.
Yep. And that's what you wanted. That was heavy.
And then folded paper towel on top of there to soak up the extra. Let's see how that looks. Because remember, that's always different. Ooh, pretty.
Ooh, look at your towel.
Ooh, pretty.
Save that towel.
So if you want to add a little bit more at this time, you probably could just pounce on a little bit more and then spritz it a little bit more.
Sure.
And you'll get a little bit more of those colors right where you want them.
And then obviously it's buckling up as it dries, it will go flat. If you haven't tried these before, they are great fun. Mm-hmm. And I will tell you that five-year-olds like these too.
Oh, I'll bet they do. Don't let them keep the bottle and walk away.
That's true.
Because this stuff is, it gets everywhere. You want to keep it in one spot. Then simply peel that up. And if this was a little bit more concentrated, you'd be able to see the image more. And in fact, if you turn to the inside of that card.
So on the front, Teresa blotted that a little bit more than what Gail just did. Mm-hmm. However, on the inside,
she really used all of the color.
Now this does have the dazzles resting on top. So you can use the same dazzle on the front as a stencil and then put it on the inside.
Absolutely.
Because you just tap off that
pixie powder. So that wasn't two separate bits of dazzle. Those
were the same ones.
Used again.
And again, we've used the long greetings, so that's right there. So you can see that there are many things you can do, and I'm not sure if I can even get all the dazzles back.
But you saw the dazzles, the embossing folders.
Lots
to choose from. Look at those. You've got corner embossing folders. You've got hearts individually. All those beautiful dazzles.
Well, I told you we're in for a fun ride. And speaking of which, please join us tomorrow for our last day in this week of webisodes. We'll see more of Teresa's wonderfulness.
See you then.